Welcome to House of the Dragon Lore. This is episode 2 of my dragon series, in which I'm going to discuss the dragon Syrax, which was the mount for Queen Rhaenyra. So the promotional photos got released from HBO, the actual official photos, and I will put a link down below in the description in case you haven't already seen them. You can check them out. So like I discussed before in my previous episode, we've seen the pictures from a distance, the blurry pictures, but these ones are actually pretty close up and you can see the costumes pretty clearly. And I mean, they're okay. The costumes are pretty good. Rhaenyra looks good, but I'm not overly impressed. I think her, like, she had a coat dress on. It had no silhouette. Like, it just hung there. It was really, like, loose. So you couldn't, like, see the silhouette of her body. It didn't tighten at all at the waist. So I would have liked it better if it had to have, like, a silhouette included in the coat dress instead of just hanging the way that it did. I did like the dragon feet that were in the middle that held on to the strings. That was a really cool detail. And I like the fact that it was a like reflected maroon color and it had like a raspberry red. And on the sleeves there was like a trim of gold. And like I said, I liked it, but I didn't love it. I'm thinking that, like, when we see her outfits in the show or maybe in more promotional pictures, they might be a bit better because we'll see some of the outfits that she'll be wearing, like the dresses, the black dress. That's one of the main parts of the Dance of the Dragon stories and all that kind of stuff. But she did look good. She had on the silver gold wig, and it was similar to Daenerys's wig, which was fantastic. And it had like a bun of braids on the top. And there was like a loose side braid, which in the books is what Rhaenyra was known to wear. The same as Queen Visenya. And she had in red earrings. They were like dangly earrings and a necklace. And I've never seen any of the characters in Game of Thrones wear earrings before, so that's quite interesting. But I do like that they added that feature in for Rhaenyra. She looked a little bit older than I thought she would, seeing that Emma D'Arcy, I think, is 28 years old, something around that. But she still looked good. Like, she had that kind of what I picture to be a Targaryen look. And it's kind of like a unique beauty, like I discussed in my previous episode about her and Dany. So it'll be nice to see more photos. And there was a photo of Daemon Targaryen, and his costume was really nice. It was like a charcoal black, and it had, I think it was like leather sleeves with dragon scales. And that was really cool. I really liked that. And it had the winged shoulders. And there was a belt with, like, dragon sigils on it. So that was cool, but I would have liked to see some red included on his costume. But I'm sure we'll see some red on him in the future. I really liked Daenerys had, like, the red cape with the dragon sigil pin. I really love that, so I would like to see some of that in this show as well. And there were pictures of, Lord Corlys Velaryon, and he had his silver dreadlocks. They were long. That looked really cool, and I liked probably his costume was probably one of the favorites of what I've seen so far. He had the Velaryon sigil on his chest, and it was like a dark greenish color, and he had a belt and leather boots. And there was, of course, Alicent Hightower, and she had on a green gown. And she was, like, drenched in gold. And she had a headpiece on. I don't know what that's called, but it was, like, a headpiece that Anne Boleyn wore in The Tudors. And the actual Anne Boleyn, I think, wore a headpiece like that because there is a painting of her. And you could see that if you search Anne Boleyn on Google. I think it's one of the only pictures of her. And she has that headpiece on. And I think they're kind of going for that look with Alicent Hightower, and Otto Hightower was also in the photo with Alicent, and he had on the green as well. But, like, I don't really care what Alison Hightower wears because I'm not a fan of the greens. I'm team black. So, really, all I care about is what Rhaenyra's wearing and Daemon and all them. That's what's most interesting to me. But it was still cool to see Alicent in her costume. So it's really begun, people, and my veins are alive and flowing with dragon blood. No purple eyes, though, so far, but I can live with that. I mean, Emilia Clarke didn't have the purple contacts in, and she looked fine because she had that unique eye color. And, I mean, I'm okay with it. I wouldn't mind seeing it, but I also like it to be more real than supernatural in certain aspects. So I'm fine either way, but it would have been interesting to see some purple eyes. Also, there's photos that keep pouring in from our spies who are keeping a close eye on the House of Dragons set on the coast of Cornwall. So my new morning ritual has become, as soon as I open my eyes, I'll start pouring the hot bath water for my morning bath. And while it's filling up, I'll check for all the House of the Dragon updates. And it's kind of like something more to get up for, you know, before work, to see if there's any new exciting news or pictures to look more into when I actually get to work, because I have an office job. So that's become my new ritual in the mornings, and I'm enjoying it. There has also been a photo circulating of a baby Targaryen, which, and when I mean baby, I don't mean actual baby. Like, he was a kid. I think it's Daeron, who was Rhaenyra's half-brother and the third youngest son of King Viserys I and Alicent Hightower. So he was Team Greens. I also saw a picture taken from a long distance of an actress wearing a scarlet red dress and had braided silver blonde hair, which I am willing to bet was Emma playing Rhaenyra. But it was that she had on like a scarlet red dress, which was really cool. I can't wait to see all those dresses, and I'm sure it's going to be really pretty. Syrax was a she-dragon. She was ridden solely by Rhaenyra Targaryen. Rhaenyra herself named her Syrax after a Valyrian goddess. Syrax the Good was the Valyrian goddess described as god of love and lust and of indulgence towards the deepest impulses. She embraces both the dark and the bright side of passion. So dragons often mirror their riders. Syrax was a large yellow she-dragon. Rhaenyra first took Syrax as a mount in 104 AC when the princess was 7 years old. Wow, I bet she was like an amazing dragon rider if she was riding for that long. Like, can you picture a little 7-year-old girl with the silver hair flying around on her yellow dragon? I bet it was quite the sight to see, and I would love to see that active, but of course we won't see that. That would be really cool to see. Syrax was described as a young dragon at the time. A year later, when she was 8 years old, Rhaenyra became a cupbearer for her father, serving him at the table, at tourneys, and at court. From that point onward, King Viserys was seldom seen without Rhaenyra. Syrax was huge and formidable, but she wasn't as fearsome or experienced in battle as Caraxes. She was kept in chains and exceedingly well-fed while Rhaenyra was at King's Landing as queen for a short time. She hadn't hunted for years at the time of the Civil War. So, like, it was kind of sad, I guess, that, I don't know, Rhaenyra had other responsibilities, maybe, so she didn't have much time for Syrax anymore. So she kind of thought that overfeeding her would compensate for, I guess, kind of just leaving her be. I wish they didn't chain up the dragons, you know. I'm sure it would have been fine to let them go freely. They're such precious assets. But it was really sad how they used to chain him up like a dog on a doghouse. Princess Rhaenyra Targaryen cheered as the realm's delight when she was young and later called the Half-Year Queen. She was the firstborn child of King Viserys I. Rhaenyra was King Viserys's only living child by his first wife, Queen Aemma of House Arryn. Rhaenyra had her family's Valyrian looks, wearing her silver gold hair in a long braid in the manner of Queen Visenya Targaryen. Beautiful as a child, Rhaenyra was later declared by her uncle, Prince Daemon Targaryen, to be the most beautiful maiden in all the Seven Kingdoms. Rhaenyra never lost weight gain from pregnancies, and she had grown stout and thick of waist at the age of 20 after her third pregnancy. And she had the big boobs too, which they say in the book, large bosom. Rhaenyra always dressed richly, as favored purple and maroon velvets and golden Moorish lace in intricate patterns. Her bodice often glittered with pearls and diamonds. When Viserys died in 129 AC, however, Sir Otto Hightower, the Hand of the King, and Sir Christian Cole, Lord Commander of the Kingsguard and possibly the former lover of Rhaenyra, defied the king's will and instead crowned Rhaenyra's half-brother, Queen Alicent Hightower's son, Aegon II, who was 10 years younger. Imagine. You know, they took the crown from Rhaenyra, and it kind of reminds me of Game of Thrones, you know? I wonder, is Alicent Hightower going to be a Cersei? I hope it's not the other way around. This brought out the Targaryen civil war known as the Dance of the Dragons, in which dragon riders fought each other. During the war, Rhaenyra rode her dragon, Syrax. Rhaenyra Targaryen would spend hours in the company of her uncle Daemon. He would praise her beauty, enthralling her with tales of his adventures, taking her hawking and mocking her stepmother Alicent and her greens. Daemon gave her books, pearls, silks, and a jade tiara once owned by the Empress of Ling. For fun, Daemon and Rhaenyra often raced to Dragonstone on their dragons. One of Syrax's most notable achievements was producing several clutches of eggs that eventually hatched into dragons that could be gifted to future Targaryens. Can you imagine in the show if, like, Rhaenyra walked out of a fire with baby dragons? But I think her power declined after difficult births, and she was never truly tested in a true battle. Syrax led the assault on King's Landing that gained Rhaenyra the crown she would lose. Following her difficult stillbirth at the beginning of the war, Rhaenyra recovered enough strength to fly on Syrax, along with her other dragon riders, when they assaulted and captured King's Landing with little opposition. In King's Landing, Syrax was kept within the walls of the Red Keep in a stable in the outer ward that had been emptied of horses and given over for her use. Heavy chains bound her to the ground. The chains were long enough to allow her to move from the stable to yard, but kept her from flying off riderless. The three other dragons belonging to the Blacks were kept in the dragon pit, along with the Greens' Dreamfire. And Dreamfire was ridden by Helaena Targaryen. When the dragon pit was attacked, Prince Joffrey wished to ride forth to protect the dragons, but Rhaenyra refused to allow it, insisting that they would need every man to defend Aegon's High Hill after the Hill of Rhaenys fell. Joffrey, fearing his own dragon, Tyraxes, would be killed, slipped away to the yard and loosened his mother's dragon, Syrax. Oh no, you know that's a mistake. Mounted on Syrax's back, the prince flew over the city. Whether it was his intent to fly the dragon into battle or to fly to the dragon pit to fetch his own dragon, Tyraxes, and perhaps the other dragons as well, is unknown. Refusing an unfamiliar rider, Syrax threw Joffrey from her back and he fell to his death on the streets of King's Landing. Syrax now descended on the survivors who came forth from the smoking ruins after the destruction of the dragon pit's roof. According to Mushroom, and Mushroom was a fool and he was a close friend of Rhaenyra, 1,000 shrieks and shouts echoed across the city, mingling with the dragon's roar. The Hill of Rhaenys looked as if it were worn, quote, a crown of yellow fire, quote, burning so bright that it seemed the sun was rising. Instead of breathing fire into the mobs from above, Syrax flew down and attacked the mob with her teeth and claws, devouring the people below. Rhaenyra watched Syrax's end from atop the roof of Maegar's Holdfast, clutching her only surviving son Aegon in her arms until Syrax fell to the ground. Oh my god, that's so sad. That's so, so sad. All these people who are just so sick of the Targaryens and the wars, so they wanted to get rid of all the dragons and they thought that would end most of their problems. So unfortunately, their anger was turned towards the dragons in the dragon pit and they just wanted to get rid of all of them. Mushroom, Septon Eustace, and Grand Maester Mucin have written down accounts of Syrax's death. According to Mucin, Hob the Hewer killed the dragon with his axe, although Archmaester Gildane believes this is almost certainly mistaken, as he considers it unlikely that the same man could have slain two dragons the same night and in the same manner. Others have suggested an unnamed spearman, quote, a blood-soaked giant, quote, who leapt onto the dragon's back, while others tell of Sir Warwick Wheaton, who supposedly slashed a wing from Syrax with a Valyrian steel sword. Bean, a crossbowman, claimed responsibility for Syrax's death afterward and boasted of it frequently until one of Rhaenyra's supporters grew tired of his stories and cut out his tongue. The loss of both her dragon and her son left Rhaenyra Targaryen ashen and inconsolable. So another interesting snippet that I found out about Syrax, doing some research, was that in the Dance of the Dragons, a true telling by Maester Mucin. I don't know if I'm saying his name right. I'm sorry. I probably said it different now 3 times. By Maester Mucin, he wrote that Vhagar roasted Sir Byron's swan when he tried to kill her by sneaking up behind his shield so the dragon would see only her reflection, as Serwyn of the Mirror Shield did to Eurax, and Eurax was a dragon who may have lived in the time of the First Men. However, according to Tyrion Lannister, Grand Maester Mucin was incorrect, and the dragon was in fact Syrax. Tyrion thinks it being Syrax makes much more sense than Mucin's version, because this is the dragon mentioned in the letter to the daughter of Sir Bywin Swan that was seen by his squire who saw the whole thing. Sir Byron was also the son of a marcher lord, and that's the name given to the lords of the Stormlands, and Storm's End was on the side of the Greens. Vhagar was ridden by Prince Aemon, King Aegon's brother and a fellow Green. It's so heartbreaking that dragons were basically abolished because of a civil war that broke out between a family. Like, you know, there's always drama in families, but can you imagine, like, basically everyone in your family, well, not everyone, most people in your family having a dragon, and you just fighting each other up in the sky on your dragons, burning all your properties just because of that cursed Iron Throne. And that's basically what kills everybody. And it just, like, it seems like there's a curse put on it, and whoever sits in it or wants it, they just don't do too well. So, you know, it's really sad. I just wish that all the dragons didn't have to die. It's just going to be so hard for me to see the dragons getting killed in such a horrific manner, especially Syrax, because Rhaenyra had to actually watch that, and it must have been heartbreaking. Like, I can't even imagine, and it's going to be hard to watch on the show as well. I'm also hoping they don't use the whips like they do in the books on the dragons, and I don't think they will. Because I don't think, like, a lot of people will enjoy seeing the dragons being whipped. I don't think it's necessary. And I don't know if they'll have the saddles on the dragons. Maybe. I'm really curious about that. But either way, I'm good. If they have the dragons saddled or if they just ride them bareback like Daenerys did. That's all I have for you right now, guys, and I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I look forward to discussing more dragon lore with you soon. Enjoy the rest of your day.